Alright, let's explore setting up the ESP32 with a CAN shield to use SavvyCAN directly to access a CAN bus through the OBD-II port. If you have been following my CAN project videos, you'll know I've already covered this topic. However, it was part of my CAN framework, using the ESP32 with the CAN shield as a general purpose ESP now bridge. I then created a custom receiver gadget to translate the frames into something SavvyCAN could understand. This approach has limitations, such as being in read-only mode. Some of you have already asked why I don't connect directly to the ESP32 and use a framework like the ESP32RET. The answer is yes, it is feasible. However, for my framework, I aim to create one gateway to serve multiple gadgets. That is why I made the SavvyCAN gadget separate from the gateway. But in this video, I'll explore bypassing the framework altogether and load the ESP32RET firmware directly on the ESP32 itself. To set up the firmware on the ESP32 and the CAN shield, I only needed to adjust one line, the one that configured the TX and RX for the CAN transceiver. On the CAN shield, TX is on 4 and RX is on 5. This should be sufficient for CAN functionalities to get working. Additionally, I made some modifications to use the extra LEDs on the shield. I have a green and a blue one to indicate Wi-Fi and CAN traffic. To get started quickly, download the firmware code, change this line and flash it to the ESP32. Alternatively, I have pre-compiled it already for you. I made it available on my online flasher, so you can install it directly from the browser without having to modify or download the code. Once the ESP32 is flashed, assemble the gateway by attaching the shield to it and plugging it into the car's OBD-II port. If you're not seeing any traffic, I recommend that you watch this video. It might explain the difference between CAN and the OBD-II port. When powered on, the red LED should light up, and once the access point is activated, this LED will stay on. When the gateway detects any CAN traffic, this other LED will also light up. These LEDs help troubleshoot power, Wi-Fi, and CAN traffic issue quickly. And now today's video sponsor, PCBWay. I've been a loyal user of PCBWay for several years, using their services for my DIY project and 3D prints. I'm a big fan of their $5 for 10 pieces promotion, allowing me to experiment without breaking the bank. If you share my passion for DIY project and looking to elevate your creations, consider giving PCBWay a try. You can find a link to their services down below. Now back to the video. When the gateway is ready, it creates an access point called wireless CAN, and the password for that access point is MrDIY.ca. Now go to the laptop or the desktop you're using that has SavvyCAN installed on it and connect to this wireless CAN access point. Enter the password and launch SavvyCAN. In the SavvyCAN settings, go to the connections and add a new network connection, and the IP address should be autofilled with 192.168.4.1. Create the connection and configure the CAN speed according to your car's CAN connection, which is typically 500 kilobits per second. And that's the whole process really. Now you have a two-way communication between the CAN bus and SavvyCAN. And this is where the fun begins. With this setup, you can now fully utilize the SavvyCAN's capabilities to not only read but also send messages on the CAN bus. This opens a wide range of possibilities for diagnostics, logging, and even creating custom controls for your vehicle. I'll leave a link to my online flasher and all the resources mentioned in the video down below. So thank you for watching and happy tinkering!